That's it. You found it. I don't know how you got it back, and I don't want to know. Frankly, I don't even care. I'm just so glad to see it again.
Is he a dark elf or a wood elf?
This is all I can afford to give you as compensation. Hope it's enough.
I guess he's a dark elf.
Watch yourself out there.
Well, I am taller than him, whatever he is.
Smear Talos's name, yet they still proudly use the coins that have his face sculpted on.
Okay, where's the wife? Usually she's out here. There was a fight going on. Hopefully she's not dead. Oh, maybe she ran off. Maybe she probably ran off and she's cowering in a corner somewhere. She's not inside. I'm not sure what immersive AI, or was it called? Immersive citizen AI? I don't know what that mod does with these farmers out here. Where they run to when there's a dragon. If they have a safe house somewhere other than their own house. Or she could just be hiding in her house for all I know. She's falling. You know, she's fallen. She's trapped under something heavy. She can't hear me. Oh, there she is.
Hello, friend.
Where did you come from?
All right, then.
We're going to send a search party out for her. Oh, great. Is this the episode where I go to this place? I don't even know what to expect when I go there because you got you sleep messing with the scripts. You got immersive patrols messing with the scripts. Okay, I shouldn't be that harsh. Immersive patrols isn't messing with the scripts. It's messing with the encounter. By throwing in immersive patrols in the mix. At that location. And I think I have immersive winches. Throwing its hat in the ring. We'll see. We're gonna go there. I don't remember. Usually the place works fine. If you just go there and what's the guy's name? Trevaz or Trevor? Treva? Whatever. That guy. You go there. Oh, I'm out of magic already. I need to practice using magic on things. Hold still, Fox. Yeah, if you go to that hideout. Oh, what's his name? Anyway, you find him on the side of the road.
Let's make a plan.
You escort him back home. And then his bandit buddies try to kill you.
Is the talking done? We've stopped. What is it? What do you need to take?
But I have a quest. Overlaid on top of that, so. You know, the people in Riften, they say, oh, you need to go kill the bandit leader.
Let's
over
bring
there.
The fight to the wicked. Let's go.
For a fully voiced follower, she doesn't really say all that much.
places.
Yeah, so you sleep. I think it takes care of the bounty. You know, kill the bandit chief that's hanging out at such and such place. But it depends on who fixed that script. If it breaks the other script where you're helping the guy get back home and his buddies give you the kibosh. Then I forgot, I'm not leveled up enough to even talk to these people. I think you have to be, what, level 11? Before they'll even acknowledge you're outside their gate.
You have no business in our stronghold, Outlander.
Great. I'll come back in.
And stay. Fight.
Get him. This Kill should him. Be good.
Who's fighting? A wolf and a goat or something? There's nothing out here. Oh, maybe it's a spider. A spider and a bear. That usually happens around here. I'm not sure why, but every time I come here, it's just the kid that's out here.
It's just me and my mother at the mill here. My father is gone. Family. You don't know what happened. Truth,
the mom doesn't come outside ever. I have to go inside the house pretty much to even meet her. So this time I thought I'd just wait. Maybe the mom will come out eventually. Because if there's wolves in the neighborhood, the parents always run indoors. But the kids, I don't know. I don't know if the kids follow the same escape route that the parents use. Because I'm always finding kids outside after a fight has happened in a neighborhood. All the adults are gone. Usually in a sci-fi story, it's, where have all the kids gone? But in this case, it's like, where are all the parents? They're gone. It's just the kids. So I guess I'm on the right road. I'm supposed to cross the river eventually on a bridge. Not that bridge. There's another bridge.
What is the purpose of freedom if it is without honor?
These stormcloaks here were giving me some issues. Oh, okay, here we are. This is the place. I fast-forwarded, so we got here much quicker. Yeah, so these stormcloaks, I thought, oh, this would be interesting. Let's watch what they do here. Before I talk to the guy at the side of the road, I'll just see what these stormcloaks do. These are from the immersive patrols. And they're just doing their immersive patrolling that they do. I thought I'd take a peek up ahead. See who it is they might be facing. If I go up there, they'll fight me. They're scripted as guards, but if you get close enough, they switch over to bandit.
I wish you would go to Cyrodiil with me someday.
Because, you know, they're not fighting me. There was no red dots. These guys are just fighting each other. So, one of these was the bandit chief that I was supposed to kill. They're coming up as guard instead of bandit. So I have no idea if that would break the quest for the guy sitting on the roadside wanting me to escort him back to his house here. In the old days, there used to be a bandit chief up here. So it looks like the bandit chief came running down to see what all the fighting was about. Because you would see these guards here, and you're like, okay, what was all this about? Because I'll pretend that I didn't see the guy at the side of the road. And I just saw these Stormcloaks walking, so I just followed them. They killed some people. And I'm thinking,
if you know any true sons and daughters of Skyrim, tell them to head to Windhelm. Ulfric Stormcloak wants to see them.
I'm thinking, all is well in Skyrim?
Are they gone?
Bandits attacked and ransacked my cart. Can you help me?
My camp is nearby in the ruins of Nilheim. Get me there safely, and you'll be rewarded.
So then I was curious, okay, who's this guy and what's he gonna do?
Across the bridge and up that hill.
Is it, you know, is it going to spawn more guards to fight me, or is he going to fight me all by himself? See the camp.
Wait here. I'll be right back with your...
Now ain't this a surprise?
he didn't last at all. So I thought, no, I'm going to do this again, because I don't want this area to be broken and not spawn any more bandits ever again for my playthrough, because that's happened in the past. This place will just stay empty. And I'll never get Radiant quests sent. I'll still get Radiant quests sending me to kill the bandit chief, but when I come here, there won't be anyone. So then I have to use the console command to finish the quest and get my bounty. So this time I thought I'd come at a different time of day.
Face my justice.
Come at nighttime for a change. I almost never come here at nighttime. But these Stormcloaks were already here.
If you know any true sons and daughters of Skyrim, tell them to head.
And they already killed everything.
Ulfric Stormcloak wants
bastards.
To
You guys suck. Okay, let's try again. So now I'm a bit farther away. It's nighttime. And I think I've waited.
Let's bring the fight to the wicked. What do you need to take?
Because I'm in a different cell. So if I wait in this cell, other cells will fast forward without stuff dying, I hope. So the immersive patrol will get out of here, get out of this neighborhood completely, I hope. And then I can meet this guy on the side of the road at night. Maybe, oh.
No mercy for the wicked.
Something was telling me that the Stormcloaks were going to be here waiting for me to show up. What is this? Oh, we got an Imperial this time. Now that Imperial, see right there, I bumped into a horse. There's an invisible horse or something I keep walking into. I don't know what the deal is. Immersive patrol is broken.
Bandits
in this location, as far as Imperials
go. My camp
go.
Is nearby in the ruins of Nilheim. Get me there safely, and you'll be rewarded.
Because there's supposed to be a bunch of Imperials coming through here, but instead it's just the Imperial leader, the Imperial captain is here, and then an invisible horse is here, and then that's it as far as the Imperials go. But the Stormcloaks, they always spawn here, and they always work. There's no invisible anything for me to walk into. So this time we're going to let him do his thing first. So these three guards will switch over to bandits once they attack us.
Now ain't this a surprise?
Don't you find magic amazing? It can do so many tasks that a man cannot.
I can't see squat.
Are you prepared to die?
For Cyrodiil! You're done plaguing this place.
See, now it says bandit instead of guard for these three dudes and dudettes. Isn't that weird? Usleep tries to fix something that's not really a thing.
We've okay. Finished another battle.
Was that the chief? Okay, that was the chief then. I thought I'd go in here. What the heck? Oh, there's someone else here. Oh, yeah. Coming at me like that. What were they thinking? My reflex action. So hopefully, for the rest of my playthrough, this area will keep respawning with bandits and bounties for me to go after, instead of it just being a ghost town for the rest of the playthrough.